checking in on your family. How are you? I'm kind of on cloud like 15 or 16 because I recently came back from a pretty great weekend away. It's called Escape with Shape at Miraval Resorts. And it's an opportunity for us over at Shape Magazine, the Brain Trust, our editor-in-chief, our fashion director, myself as the fitness director, to come together and create important conversations amongst women, to learn from each other, to coach and support one another, and also to kind of lead by example in that small capsule and start to go into our lives beyond that. And ironically, one of the greater takeaways that I had going out of the weekend was this power of simple. And it came through unexpectedly. Brooke Danielson, who is our editor, our fashion director, editor, rock star, she just ran the New York Marathon. Big ups to all of you that did that as well. I have literally a little card, and she kept saying, it's like, it's okay to have fun, stand out. And I literally have notes written about that. And when I thought about that, I'm like, oh my gosh, that's something that I struggle with somewhat the most. So what I took is a very surface level comment about having fun, having a little risk. I mean, literally today, I have my little hat on and my little red sweater with my sweatpants. But when I walked in today, I got complimented by two people. And it was because I'm taking this little bit of risk, this little small twist of simple, and putting it into just the way I chose my clothes for today. And it was ironic that I started to implement what she said during the weekend. Very small, you know, like we had these little, like cute little lip stains. And so I had packed, of course, like a black on black outfit. And so I put this red lip stain on before I taught class. And everyone's like, wow, so fancy, you're so dressed up. And because of that kind of feedback from people, I was just kind of amped. I was up. I was excited to teach. The music I chose was a little more adventurous. And it was weird how that small power of simple shifted my ability to do what I can do with my eyes closed when I teach a class. And it brought more out of me and therefore connected me more deeply to the people around me. So how funny that shortly after Brooke's presentation on style, right? Elizabeth Goodman, our editor-in-chief, was talking about finding your why. And on the top of her list was that why has to be simple. And one of the gals there said, well, I'm unhappy, and my why is to be happy. And Elizabeth goes, that's not very simple. And I'm thinking, well, it kind of is, just be happy. But we started to break down what it looked like, and this is where I wanted to bring it back to you guys. This power of simple, this one idea of one change in your life to light up something further in you, but also the ability to be simple and break down what it really is that you're going for and what's an actionable takeaway that you can do to apply so you actually see progress in your life because your why is simple enough and clear enough to actually be a tactical, usable, living, breathing thing in you every day. So going to the story with the gal, why was to be happy, right? And then she and Elizabeth kind of said, well, what's further than that? And we were kind of talking through it as women, like, well, what does it mean to be happy? What does it mean to unhappy? She said she wasn't waking up every day feeling very excited. I'm like, okay, well, why aren't you waking up excited, right? So you kind of get, you go, and as Elizabeth used, excavate, what's further, what's beyond there? And then she wasn't excited about going to her job. And we're like, oh, okay. So what is it about your job that are you unexcited about? And by the end of this simplification process, we discovered that it was being at a job that she felt unchallenged and unsupported. And so is the simple why, I need to quit my job to be happy? No, it was actually the simple why became, I want to identify what does make me feel supported, what does make me feel challenged. And that's the way that I'm going to start to direct these sales toward, whether it's career, whether it's life and family. Because let me tell you guys, how easy is it to point like that front row of people in your life, My mom, my dad, my sister, my brother, my friends, my spouse, my, right? They catch all the stuff because we're not simplifying why we're unhappy or why what's making us mad, and actually using that not as a negative feeling or not as that as a negative reason to be upset and stay unhappy, but as useful intel to say, oh, I can actually redirect the sales. I can use this information to go forward a different way and start to make those tactical daily steps in my day to simplify and go towards what I want. So, you know, moral of the story, the power of simple, whether that's putting on a little lippy before your workout or brightening up your sweater or really simplifying the process of the source of where you're feeling joyful or where you're not. That power of simple really resonated with me, and it's carried with me now into literally my daily thinking. So that is my challenge for you this week. Keep it simple, use the power of that, and I'll see you soon.